Hi everyone, welcome to the channel. So today let's try to explore a function called split fixed asset. As the name says, it is related to fixed assets module. But what is the scenario, or what are the cases where we can use split functionality related to fixed assets? So let's take an example. Let's say I'm purchasing a machinery. Now when I purchase a machinery, I don't want to capitalize this. Therefore, I will put it to a FA group called CWIP, that is capital work in progress. At a later stage, now I want to move from capital work in progress to actual group where I want to calculate depreciation. Let's say I have a group called plant and machinery. When I post acquisition, I would have posted acquisition to CWIP group. Now that I want to capitalize my machinery, I can move this to plant and machinery. It's also possible that I can have acquired multiple machinery and just one machinery currently I want to move. That is when we can use split functionality instead of reclassifying the group, right? And also it's possible I would have other assets grouped into CWIP. Now there's one catch here. Unfortunately, from MSD perspective, I cannot move CWIP to plant and machinery based on quantity. So it should be based on amount. That's one disadvantage. And the second thing is I cannot create multiple fixed assets. It has to be just one fixed asset. So there are a few restrictions in that way, but at least there's a feature. So let's try to explore how it works, right? So let's go to MSD. So let's go to fixed assets. I've actually created two different fixed assets. So in terms of setup related to creating fixed assets, I think I'll make a separate video where we will have a walkthrough of setup related to fixed assets. So this video is more related to split functionality. So as you see here, I have created two different fixed assets. One is CWIP, one is plant and machinery. So now let's see how I can split CWIP into plant and machinery. So before that, let's try to understand the accounting entry, right? So now, at the time of moving my transaction from CWIP to plant and machinery, so as acquisition is done on P&M, my plant and machinery should be debited. This debit credit. So my plant and machinery should be debited by whatever amount I'm moving, and my CWIP should be credited. So this is how it should be posted. But from MSD perspective, we have a restriction from MSD when there are two FA in one voucher, system will not allow you to post this transaction because this is restrictions. So how do we go past that restrictions, right? So instead of posting in one voucher, I will split that into two different voucher. So in one voucher, I will debit plant and machinery. Let's say we will put one control account, which gets credit. Now there will be second entry where my control account gets debited and my CWIP accounts gets credited. So in this way, my control account is negated, the balance is zero. So there's a debit entry for my new asset, which is plant and machinery, and there's a credit entry on the existing one, that is my CWIP. So this is how we post transaction in MSD. So let me just mark this. Now, there is one feature. So generally in the journal name setup, if you see, okay, let me show that. I have created one journal name for posting split functionality. So let's say general ledger, journal setup, journal names, right? So you can see here, I have created split FA transaction. So at the time of splitting, I will select this particular journal name, and my fixed assets will be splitted. This one catch. So here, if you see the voucher series, I have taken in connection with balance. So until and unless debit credit is there, obviously system will pick one voucher number for both the transaction. And again, we get the error that FA to FA is not allowed in MSD. So there is one option, or there is currently in version 39, it's in feature management. Maybe it gets parameterized going forward. So let me quickly go to feature management. So go to all. have just enabled this. We need to enable this as of now. Maybe in future, hope MSD makes this mandatory. So if I see here, there is one functionality or a feature that says that create separate voucher number for journal lines related to, if you see what are the actions, one of the action is split functionality. So whenever I use split functionality, by default, system will split voucher number into two. If you see my journal names, it's the same setup that in connection with balance. But since I've enabled this feature that says create separate voucher number, as soon as I create my split functionality, irrespective of what setup we have at the journal names, this is transaction will be splitted into two voucher number. So that way I can just select control account and post the transaction. So let's execute one transaction. So let's go to fixed assets. Fixed assets. Okay. So here I have two fixed assets. So you can see your CVIP. If I go to books, balance, you can see acquisition 80,000, my net book value is 80,000. So this is the CVIP where I will do the split functionality. Let me also, as a reference, open one more fixed asset, which is plant and machinery, where I want to split my asset into. Now, before splitting, this has to be manually created. Like you can see in my FA register, plant and machinery fixed assets is something I have manually created. What split asset does, it will only post the transaction, right? As I told you initially, it's a drawback that system will not auto create FA. We have to manually create it. So if I go inside this plant and machinery, go to books, currently if you see the value is zero. So let's say balance, you can see there is no acquisition or there is no transaction posted to this fixed assets. Now let's execute the split functionality. So I'm back to fixed assets, which was CVIP, where there is a balance. So this is the acquisition transaction which I had posted. Now I want to capitalize this. Basically, I want to move to a new fixed assets from CVIP. Not entire thing, just a partial amount I want to move. Let's assume this 80,000 is part of like four fixed assets or eight fixed assets, right? So I just want to move one as of now. So go to functions. You can see split fixed asset. Click on split fixed asset. So here system asks to which fixed asset I need to move. So here select the new fixed assets which I have just created. Select and then to book. Book is also manually needs to be selected. At what date you want to move, you can select the transaction date. Here it's not based on units, as I said, it's based on percentage. So I'll say 10%. So 10% from CVIP will move to new fixed assets. Journal names, select the journal names which needs to be used to split FA. Remember, we have enabled a feature, whenever I'm splitting it will create two journal names. So let's use split FA transaction journal names created for that purpose. Click OK. So as soon as I clicked OK, you can see split fixed assets transaction has been placed in journal numbers. It has created one journal with the number. So let's go to that particular journal. So go to fixed asset journal entries, fixed assets journal. If you see here, the number was 005. So you can see this is the general batch number. Go to lines. As I explained in the Excel sheet, you can see there is two lines with two different voucher number, and there is one adjustment, that is the CVIP where it is credited, and there is acquisition, that is new fixed assets, which is debited. So if you see here, new fixed assets debit, and old fixed assets, my CVIP is credited. I have to just assign offset account. So I have created one control account. So I'm just going to assign that FA control account here and one FA control account here and save. So once I save, let me post this transaction. Once the transaction is posted, so let's just go back. So this is my plant and machinery asset, which was not acquired. Now that I've posted the transaction, refresh, you can see it is acquired. If I go to balance, it says acquisition 8,000. Similarly, if I just go back to the CWIP fixed assets from which I created, so if I go to books and go to valuations here or balance, you can see from 80,000 I have reduced 8,000, so the net book value is 72, for which there is no depreciation. There's a new fixed assets which is created for which I can, you know, start using depreciation. So that is how we can use split FA functionality. Thanks everyone.